Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Moza Force Feedback Review, coming up on today's episode of 2020 Flight Simmers. Welcome back. Before we get started, I have one disclaimer. Moza sent me these products for review. However, that will not influence anything that I'm about to show you today. Non-affiliate links for all of these products will be down below in the description if you would like to pick one up. Oh, and if you missed the intro video to the entire product series, I will post links down below for that. That will explain the reason why I've done this product series in the first place. In today's video, we'll be reviewing the Moza AB-9 base, as well as the MH16 right-handed stick, and the mount for the base itself. We will first go over a quick unboxing of all the products, and then a brief overview of all of the hardware. We'll then take a deeper dive into the Moza Force Feedback base, and I will remove the cover exposing all of the internals. This is to allow me to show you all of the electronics and the hardware that's being used inside of the unit. We will then jump over to the developer's website, take a look at all the pricing, as well as the different stick options that they have available. I will then mount everything up to my sim cockpit, launch the Moza software, do any firmware updates, and then the fun begins. We will spawn into the sim and demo the product. During this time, I will also be testing the max forces on the unit, as well as stick compatibility from other manufacturers. I would like to give Scott over at Moza Racing a big thank you for sending these products out for review. With that, if you have any comments throughout today's video, post them down below in the comments section and I'll get right back with you. If you enjoyed today's content, make sure to hit that subscribe, tick on that little bell, and smash that thumbs up button. It is greatly appreciated. Let's start with the Moza base first. Now let's move on to the Moza stick. And now the mounting bracket. Now let's go over some close-ups of all of the hardware. We'll start with the mounting bracket first. All right, after some close inspection of the unit, it looks like we have some rubber pads here on the front. On the back side, we also have some rubber inside of the clamp as well. I'm gonna measure the max thickness that this mount can accommodate for your desk. We will call that just about 68 millimeters. It might be a little bit more, but I probably wouldn't go over 68 millimeters to mount this. Let's take some measurements on the metal itself. There we go, just over 4 millimeters. And then where these brackets are, they're even thicker. So let's measure that. And this is without the padding. We are almost 10 millimeters thick for the bracket. All right, now let's throw it on a scale so you can get an idea on the weight. And there you go, 1,514 grams. Just to give you some overall dimensions, from side to side, the unit's about 146 millimeters. My caliper doesn't go all the way, but we're probably right around 165 millimeters from top to bottom here. Okay, let's take a closer look at the MH16 flight stick. Oh, look at that. Wow. Okay, I hope I got that on camera, but the switch on top of here just fell right off. So just to show you what's going on in here, that's what's underneath of this little hat switch. That's what came out here. Let's see if I can get these back on. The actual construction of the stick itself looks like it's metal. I do have a magnet, and the magnet doesn't stick to it, so it could be aluminum. And there you go. I hope you can see that. Yes, the entire stick is made of metal. Most likely it's made of aluminum. So they have some really nice labels up here. And down on the bottom. As far as the fitment of the stick with my hand, and I'm put some measurements in here on my hand, but I don't know if you can see this, it actually feels pretty tight on my hand. Doesn't give me a lot of movement. On the bottom of this stick, on the right hand side, there is an adjustment here so that you can raise your hand rest. Now I want to take some measurements on the handle itself so you have an idea of the thickness of this handle. So we are 37, just over 37 millimeters from front to back on the stick. So we'll take it from the fattest part and we are just a little over 49 millimeters wide from left to right. And there you go, we're just a little over 104 millimeters of usable space for your hand. That's how big my hands are from side to side. All right, now let's throw this on the scale and get a weight on that. There you go, 539 grams. Now let's take a look at the force feedback base. That I noticed as when I'm moving around the stick, it's got some rubbing action going on here. Sounds like something is rubbing against this pleather or leather, whatever this is. On the back of the force feedback base, this is where we're going to connect the power supply, the USB to our PC, and any other pieces of hardware that are in the Moza ecosystem for flight simulation. On the bottom of the base, we have some rubber pads to keep it still on your desktop. And they also give us some other mounting options for the base as well. All of the dimensions for these mounting holes are on the Moza website. I'll show you that here in a moment. Now let's get some measurements on the base. So we are about 6 1/4 inches from side to side at its widest point. Front to back, we are just over 9 1/4 inches. And top to bottom, we are about 7 1/4 inches. All right, let's throw this on a scale and get a weight on that. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna use this scale and hopefully I'll be able to hang it here. Oh boy. Just over 12 pounds. All right, so now let's open up the case on the Moza base and I'll bring you guys in for a closer look. Let's get started. Oh, and one disclaimer. I do not recommend anything of what I'm about to show you right now. I do not recommend opening up the case as it may void your warranty. I am doing this so you don't have to. Let's get started. Okay, we're opened up. Now come on in for a closer look. What we're looking at here is the front of the unit. This top pulley is going to control the roll axis and is connected to the motor pulley below via a cog belt. Here's a close-up shot of the electronics with all of the motor connections on the board. As you can see here, they're using an STM32 chip. This is the back of the pitch axis motor. This is the backside of the roll axis motor, and this also gives us a great shot of the base of the case of the unit. This is the right side of the base. The pulley that we're looking at here is going to control the pitch axis. Also take notice of the main bracket that the pulley is connected to here. This is solid aluminum. that does connect to the bottom of the base via some screws. This is a close-up of the center of the unit where the joystick connects. As you can see here, all the axes are supported by sealed bearings. This is another close-up shot looking back at the pitch axis pulley. This is a close-up shot of the opposite side of the pitch axis pulley. The main support bracket that connects this to the base is hollow. If we take a look down inside of the unit here, this is the bump stop that's going to prevent the pitch from exceeding its limits. This is another shot from the left-hand side looking in. This long metal rod is going to be the bump stop for the roll axis. The only issue that I saw during inspection was the strain relief on the back of the roll axis motor cable hits the bottom of the case. All right, we've got everything back together now. Let's install the stick, and then I'm going to measure the total degrees of motion that the stick has from front to back. The first thing we need to do to install the stick is to pull out the cable on the bottom to give us some room to work with. The other thing you want to take notice of on the bottom of this stick is there is not a relief, but a protrusion here that is going to fit in the relief of the star pattern on the Moza base. Now there is one drawback to this, and that is if you don't want the stick straight forward and say you have your stick off to the side and you want to curve it a little bit or twist that stick a little, you cannot do that with this. On the base itself, there's a little arrow here, and you want to line that up with the arrow that is on the cable. Okay, so I'm around this side of the camera. It's easier for me to show you this way. So as you can see here, I'm going to push the stick all the way forward, and we're going to zero us out. Now I'm going to pull the stick all the way backward. And there you go. Now let's mount the Moza base to the desk mount bracket. And for that, we have a nice little hardware kit that we need to open up and get installed. I just want to show you the mounting technique that Moza is using to mount the base to the bracket itself. And they're using these little T-nuts. And they're going to slide inside just like this. And then you will tighten these down on the back side of the bracket to keep it in position. Inside the hardware kit for the mounting bracket, they also give us some small bolts that will screw into the bottom of the unit. So if you want to mount this to your cockpit that way, and also the bigger bolts that are in here will fit inside of the bigger holes on the bottom. And we should be able to just slide this on. Oh boy, is this a little fiddly. Trying to get these T-nuts all lined up is a bit of a pain, so I'm thinking I can insert the T-nuts, and then we'll just line those up with the bolt holes. All right, so now that we have the bracket mounted on the front of the Moza base, I hope you can see a little problem that you might experience or run into if you have the base mounted all the way to the bottom of the bracket. It would have been nice if Moza made a standoff to mount to the bracket so it would push the base out a little bit from your desk. So Moza, if you're listening, maybe you can design a desk mount that is going to offset the base from your desk, and I would offset it as much as the stick hangs over. So this way, when you push full forward on the stick, it only comes to right here on the base and you won't hit anything. Let's hop over to the Moza website and we'll take a look at some of the pricing and some of the stick options that they have available. All right, we're on the Moza website, and as you can see, the force feedback base is $549. The estimated shipping time is 7 to 10 days. And if we go down a little bit further, you can see the prices for their sticks that they have compatible with the base. The MH16 flight stick that we're reviewing today is $169, and the Moza MA3X side stick for your Airbus is $79. The desk mount for the Moza base is $49. If we scroll all the way down to the bottom, here you can see they give you some mounting ideas with their mounting bracket. And if we go all the way down to the download section, here's where we can find the user manual as well as the Moza software that you need to run the unit. Here is the schematic for the mounting hole location on the bottom of the Moza base. Now let's take a look at the other stick option that Moza has for their base. This is the Airbus side stick, the MA3X. Now one thing that you'll notice about this side stick is that they do not have a left-handed model. Now if we go to the reviews on this, you can read through all these reviews yourself, but the consensus is, why don't you have a left-handed side stick? Okay, with all that out of the way, let's jump over to the cockpit. We'll get everything mounted up, and then we will take a look at the Moza software for any firmware updates. And then the fun begins. I'll see you back in just a moment. All right, so now that we have everything mounted up, you might start to see some of the issues that you could encounter when you have this thing mounted up to your desk in this way. The first thing is, like I said earlier, the stick goes past your desk. So anything on your desk, it's going to hit. So as you can see here, I can't go full forward and right because I'm going to hit my cockpit that I have here. Now, the other thing you might be thinking right now is, well, you've got this on your left-hand side. How are you going to use that with your left hand? Well, that's a good question, and I'm not. We're going to be testing out other sticks from other manufacturers to see if they will work on the Moza base. All right, I've got everything connected up to my PC now. I have also moved my bracket over a little bit so that I don't hit my sim cockpit. And you want to be very careful with this because once it runs through its calibration process, this stick is going to be moving all over the place. There we go. And there you go. Now you can see the stick moving. All right, now that we're in the Moza software, we're going to head down to the little icon on the left-hand side. And this should be where we can update the firmware. And looks like with the latest firmware, they adapted to support third-party joysticks, so we will see how that goes here in a second. I don't know if the camera caught that, but this trigger here on the front actually got caught on the side of the bracket when it was going through its calibration. There we go. We are now on the current version. So we can close out of this. Now that we're back on the main screen, let's go ahead and click on the MH16 stick and see if there's any calibration here. Now, one of the things that I notice here, if you go up to grip type select and you tick on the drop down, we have several other sticks here that we have available. So let's hit start calibration. All right, there we go, calibration complete. You can set up your D-pad, the hat switch here, to work as either a button or a D-pad. So that is really cool. All right, now let's go ahead and check out the base. So we'll click on the base on the left-hand side. Over on the presets, we have all of the different simulators, and we also have a drop-down to select some presets. At the bottom, we're able to browse different presets, export presets. So if I create a profile and want to send it to someone, I can do that from here. Under the basic settings, under force feedback mode, here is where you're going to choose where you're going to get the force feedback information from. Then below this, we have a bunch of different basic settings that we can adjust for the stick. So if I turn the spring all the way up, and you can see how it just springs back. With the damper, we can turn that up. And you see it doesn't just spring back, it gives a dampening effect. That's pretty cool. Below damper is inertia. Now, inertia is a weird setting here because what inertia will do, it will initially take some of the force required to get it moving. And then once you stop, you will feel that force come back. Now, something I want to point out on the stick as I'm going through this if you pull back on the stick, it seems to get to a stopping point, but then you can pull it a little bit further. It's so weird because it almost feels like a detent that it's going into. And it does the same when you push forward. You get to a stop and then... So that's just something to be aware of. All the way on the right-hand side, under Axis Inputs, looks like we can do some auto calibration, and we can individually calibrate each axis as well. Down on the lower right-hand corner, this is where we can start a new preset. In Expert Settings, here's where we're going to be able to set our dead zone for the joystick. Now let's head over to Telemetry and Force Feedback. On the left-hand side, under General Aircraft Effects, we can turn on and off the G-force effect, and we can control the G-force curve. So we have a bunch of different curves over on the right-hand side, and we can also select the minimum Gs and the maximum Gs. And then we have a bunch of different options down here below. To the right, we have propeller aircraft effects. We have jet aircraft effects next to that. And then we have the helicopter effects all the way on the right-hand side. So this is what we're going to be focused on today. At the top, we have the VRS state, or the vortex ring state. So we have a bunch of different settings here. Then we have ETL effects, and then heli engine rotor rumble. And then we have overspeed vibration and a couple settings down here. Now let's head over to axis travel at the top. For those of you who are in the situation like I am for mounting, where the stick can bang into something that you may have on your desk or too close to it. In the axis travel, here's where we can actually adjust how much movement we're gonna have with the stick. We're gonna use the X-axis first. From side to side, you can see that I'm hitting my cockpit here. And now what I'll do is I will just turn back the positive travel limit. And there you go. Now what I would do is turn the other side to the exact same, and now I don't hit into my cockpit. Under axis force, this looks like a way for us to adjust the force curve of the unit itself. So we're just going to keep these on linear as well. In the special tab, we have another really cool effect here that says hardware trim mode. What hardware trim will allow us to do is to use the trim button on the joystick to not only control the trim in the aircraft, but to get the feedback that we would feel using the trim in the aircraft. For instance, if we're in a Cessna 172 and we're in a climb, we can trim it for climb, and you will feel the pressure release off of the stick when we trim. So we tick on this, you can see we have a couple things here that we can program. All right, that pretty much takes care of all the menus. If we head back over on the left-hand side, we have options for the throttle quadrant as well as the force feedback rudders. Now there's one last thing that I want to go over, and I probably should have done this first. On the right-hand side of the homepage is your game list. This needs to be set up for any game that you're going to be using the force feedback with. So we need to hit configure. From here, we need to configure the installation game path for the sim or game that you want to set this up for. If you bring your mouse over top of this little icon, it will give you an example of where the game path will be located for each of these. Now, when I set my initial game path up for this, it automatically set all of these other ones up for me. Once you get that done, then we can close out of that. For today, let's try this out in Microsoft FlightSim 2024. Before we jump into the sim, I have one more test that I want to do, and that is the max force that this stick can provide. So I'm going to turn all the settings up to 100%. And then I'm going to throw my scale on the stick, and we're going to measure the maximum back pressure that I have on this stick. There we go. We're tarred out. All right, and that's it. That's all the way back to that detent that I told you I felt. If I go through that detent, and we're just about 8 pounds of force. So there you have it. We have about 8 pounds of force on the stick when you pull it all the way back. There's one more thing that I want to do before we jump into the sim, and that is to test out sticks from other manufacturers on here to see if they will work with this setup. So with that, I'm going to go grab the Virpil Constellation Alpha joystick. We're going to throw it on here and see what happens in the software. First, we need to make sure that we power down the unit before we unplug and plug anything in. So let's go ahead and get that done. Now let's throw on the Virpil Constellation Alpha left-handed joystick so that I'll be able to use this with my setup. Let's see if it works. Now the one thing that you will have flexibility with is we have no detents on the bottom of this, so we can turn it any way we want when we clamp this thing down. Yes, it is going to run through another calibration, so just be careful with that. All right, so now that we have the stick on, we need to go up to the stick icon, and we're just going to change this to the Virpil Alpha. Now that we have selected that, we're going to run through the calibration one more time. All right, that finishes that. Now we're going to move on to the axis calibration. All right, so as you can see, all of the button mapping had populated for the Virpil Constellation stick, and all of the calibration went through fine. Now let the fun begin. We're going to spawn into Microsoft FlightSim 2024 and test out the Moza force feedback base. I'll bring you guys back in just a moment. All right, we're ready to go. Everything is set up here. I've got everything programmed. So let's get some power on in the aircraft. Wow, okay, so after takeoff, you can definitely feel the rotor vibration. I don't know if you can see the stick moving. Yeah, you can probably see the stick moving now. It is something getting used to when you have a dead stick like this. When you're used to fighting against spring forces, this is way different. So while we're in a hover, you can see the stick is just barely moving here. Now when I transition into forward flight, you can see that the stick is not moving anymore. Oh, look at this. In the parking lot, there are hay bales. Go figure. Thank you, Microsoft 2024. Alright, for my final conclusion about the Moza force feedback base, all I can say is it's a game changer, for sure. As far as the motion of the base, it is very smooth, except for that little bit of vibration when you go to full extent and you have the spring force all the way up. You feel the vibration of the motor trying to fight you back. Now, maybe there's a firmware update that can fix that, and maybe I'm just nitpicking. As far as their joysticks, please make left-handed joysticks. However, I think it was a great idea to update the firmware to allow sticks from other manufacturers to be used on your unit. So if you want to have the most realistic experience possible, the force feedback is the way to go. The software is polished, the hardware is pretty solid, so you make the decision on whether this is going to be right for you. All right, that's going to wrap us up for today's video. If you have any comments or questions, post them down below in the comments section, and I'll get right back with you. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure to hit that subscribe, tick on that little bell, and smash that thumbs up button. To all of my flight simmer friends around the world, keep the blue side up, and we will see you on the next one. Thanks for watching, everybody.